The blame on my sister Beth. 3 years old, we had like 17 boys that lived on our street. Two girls, my sister and my next door neighbor. But she was always spinning Elvis records. So at 3 and 4 years old, that's what we were listening to, me and a buddy that lived across the street. And I knew the impact that it had on my sister and her friends. And me and my buddy, Jim, we said, man, that's pretty cool. And we just kind of fell in love with the music. And it just really, it stuck with me. I was working like anybody else, working 40, 50, 60 hours a week, and two girls in school, having pain in a hip, and went to the hospital, and they couldn't find it. They had done a couple x-rays and CAT scans or MRIs, and they found a spot on my pancreas. The doctor at the hospital there said, you know, your blood work looks fine. He goes, so we're not real concerned about it. He goes, but I really would like to do a biopsy if you don't mind. A couple days later, came back. Positive, and oh, you have pancreatic cancer. We had gone to another facility for the initial appointment, and my daughter just really wasn't comfortable with that facility, and that doctor thought we need to find somebody more experienced. So we went to Fox Chase, and they saved my life. From the minute we came in, we felt like we were a part of their family. They told us exactly what we were looking at. They didn't pull any punches, but they also said, listen, you're in a good place, and whatever it is you're gonna need, you're gonna get it. And there were lots of things that I needed, both emotionally and medically, and they took care of that. It was a very difficult operation, but they made sure that I wasn't in pain. They made sure that I was taken care of 24/7. I remember Dr. Hoffman coming in and saying, you know, you're right on that line. I can keep you in. What do you wanna do? Do you want me to get better? Get me home. But every day, I had a phone call, every day, to make sure this was right, that was right. So I never felt like I was alone. And then after I got done with my treatments and got over my operation, I moved to the beach. I was out with my brother Earl one night. There was a band playing. He got me up singing with a couple songs. Next thing I know, lady asked to hire me to do a show at a local assisted living facility. And that was January 8th, 2010, Elvis's birthday. And that's where it started. And my brother Earl goes, man, you should really do this. And literally, he took me out a couple days after that and bought my first set of equipment. And that's how it got started. Myself and my band, we do a lot of shows here for the Wounded Warrior Weekend program. They all have something in common because they're all vets. But even as a non-vet, you feel like you're part of the family. It felt good to be able to give back. Not everybody is going to be as lucky as I am. And I was very lucky, very lucky. And so it's my obligation to do that. To reach out and to help, even in just a message, to say that there is hope.